So I've been so Kalashnikov USA finally released their American-made mag here. So I want to do just an initial impressions. I just took it out of the box. I bought two of them. But the main purpose of this video is to review the mag, initial impressions, and also talk about why I have switched from steel mags to only polymer mags. I finally believe that there are polymer mags tough enough to take the abuse of a real Russian polymer mag, which is this one right here. I don't know if the Kalashnikov USA 1 is tough yet because I just took it out of the box, but I'm going to share my opinions about these four polymer mags as compared to the steel Russian mag. This is actually a Russian mag here. And then we'll talk about it. So I'm going to get the camera in close here and we'll bring out the scales and show you why I chose to do this. So the point is to kind of do this live to make my point. I have a little mail scale here that I got at a thrift shop. I believe it's set to ounces. Yeah, it's hard to see through the camera. So this is a Russian mag. All I really have is I bought like 20 of these Russian mags when you can get them for $9 a piece. So you guys paying $100 for these things are a joke. I have a couple Polish mags too, but they've all been repainted, so I know this is one of my Russian ones. And they're tough as nails. They can break. I've bent the floor plates on them and broke them, and I've seen them crack, but they're pretty tough. They're going to be around longer than me. Here's my point right here. Look at that. That thing is almost 12 ounces, 11.4 ounces. That is a heavy magazine. And then it's an extra pound when you put the ammo in it. But if you take a look here, this is an authentic Kalashnikov Concern magazine. I paid a lot of money for it. They've pretty much doubled from what I paid for this one. I think I paid about 150 bucks for it, which would be a good deal now. This is genuine. It's got steel lugs in the front and back. It has steel reinforced feed lips. It feels pretty tough. Let's take a look at this. That thing is 7.8 ounces. It's pretty much a quarter pound lighter than just the steel mag. So could you imagine carrying six or eight of these things? You know, six times, let's say six times eight is 24 ounces. That's almost 2 pounds. Eight is 2 pounds. So just switching to polymer mag saves you 2 pounds in your kit. Not include, you know, because this is technically transparent. Like you need the mags no matter what. The ammo is going to weigh the same. So when you have like a $200, $300 mag, I can't afford to buy a whole bunch of them. That's just crazy. So I pretty much just have this for my AK-104 clone. So the one thing that is useful, these are tough Bulgarian mags. These are super tough, steel reinforced feed lips and the front and back locking lugs. You know, this is a Circle 10 mag, pretty ubiquitous in the for AK collectors. It's 8.8 ounces. It's a little bit heavier than the Kalashnikov magazine because I believe it has a steel feed lip straight down the spine. The problem with these is they're 60 bucks. You know, hey, if you need four, that's fine. You know, or five, just buy five and spend the 300 bucks or whatever and buy all that you need. I got, you know, four or five of these guys for different guns. But that's still pretty expensive for a mag. So next came the Magpul. I don't like the red follower Gen 1, but I really like these M3s because they have metal reinforced front and rear locking lugs. I believe they have a spine down them too, down here. I don't know. They do feel heavier than the plastic ones. These work pretty good. The only trouble sometimes is this little hump here makes it tough to insert them into mags. Not a big deal. I have a handful of these. As you can see, this is one of my practice mags. The practice ones have tape. 7.3 ounces. If you compare it to the Russian one, I believe that's lighter. Yep, 7.8. So it's a little bit lighter than the Russian one. These have been very reliable. I've had no problems with them. I've probably put, you know, if you include all the rounds I've shot, because for a long time, these are the only ones you can get, and they're 25 bucks. That's not bad. That's a lot cheaper than the Bulgarian or the Russian ones. And then you still save a quarter of a pound of weight just changing to polymer. So then the lifesavers came in. These guys right here. This is a Bulgarian mag, I believe only imported by Gun Mag Warehouse. They have this little mark here. You can see all the famous gun YouTubers start to use them. They have metal front and back locking lugs. And they have metal reinforced feed lips. These are tough as nails mags. They look almost exactly the same as the Russian mags. Like, most people would never notice the difference besides maybe the front rib details there. These are, when I saw these, because Gun Mag sells three different versions of this. They sell one that's only polymer. It's like 11 bucks. They sell one with the metal tabs, and then they sell one with a whole metal cage. And this is the one with the metal cage all in this plastic. So you got to pay extra. You know, during the freak out, they were about $24, but since prices have kind of normalized, they've gone back down to 18 bucks. I bought a ton of these. As you can see, I bought a ton of them. I have a lot. So this guy is 7.6 ounces. It's pretty much in between both of the other plastic mags. So this guy is really kind of what saved my bacon. I can kit out pretty much all of my AKs and save pounds of weight. And it's still tough. Like, I haven't really shot this one, but there are five or six of them I use for practice, and I put 3,000 rounds through them without any issues. They've been fine. You can tell I've never really inserted this one because it's still got all of its paint on its metal cage here. Now, the lady of the ball is this Kalashnikov concern, or Kalashnikov USA magazine correction. It pretty much feels exactly the same as the Russian one. We're going to weigh it here, and then I'll get the scale out. So here's the Russian one, 7.8. This one is, feels a little lighter to me, 7.3. Yeah, so it pretty much weighs exactly what the Magpul weighs. I don't know how they decided to do this, how to make this mag, but I'm happy that they finally introduced it, because these Bulgarian ones are excellent, and I would buy as many as I could afford. But the problem is, anything that's imported will soon not be imported. It might be 5 years, it might be 1 year, it might be a month. But eventually, these will stop being imported, and they will become a finite item. But, and same with these. I mean, it hasn't happened yet, but that doesn't mean it won't happen. But the nice thing about having an American source of magazines is there is still a continuous supply of mags. You know, Magpul might not be making any of these right now because they don't have the demand for them, but eventually they might. So they have the capability to make them. And it's always good to get more things in the marketplace. So I'm pretty excited about this. I assume it's going to function fine. The question is, how durable is it? Is it going to be as durable as this Russian mag? I mean, really? I mean, besides that kind of seam line hump, they pretty much are identical for all intents and purposes. I bought two of them. I'm going to try and put maybe 500 rounds through them as soon as I can. They are labeled USA on them. The follower and the body have them. I haven't looked at the floor plate yet. We'll check it out here. You know, so I think they've done a pretty good job at least replicating the Russian mag. Let's see if the floor plate says USA. Yeah, it does. So this is three compliance parts for you guys who still care about that stuff in 2021. But I'm pretty happy that they introduced this mag. I think it's good to have a good, tough, solid mag. And the nice thing is it's a much slimmer profile than this Magpul. Let me go get it. I'll get it. I got one of the U.S. Palm. Let me go weigh it. Okay. I got the X-Tech mag. This is the actual steel, metal reinforced locking lugs. I believe this has a metal cage in it too, so it is tough. There's nothing wrong with the way they work. I think they work fine. I think they're just huge. Like, look how much bigger it is. So it's tough to fit in some of the mag pouches. You know, they you can obviously see here how thin it needs to be versus how thick they made it on the sides. And I know this is an original US Palm. It is not an X-Tech mag. So I've had this for a long time. It actually came with one of the old Saigas I bought. So this is a legit old school US Palm. They still make this under the X-Tech brand. They bought all the stuff when US Palm went belly up. But let's weigh it here and see how it compares. It feels pretty heavy. Let's see if you can see that here. Let's go on. And let's wait for ounces. 7.5. So it is actually pretty light. It's in the same ballpark as the Magpul mag. But it's just big. It makes it hard to carry, hard to fit in packs. It's longer. I know it's hard to line up a curve, but it is substantially longer because of that floor plate design. I guess not. I guess they shortened it up. You can't remove the floor plate. I guess it's not longer. It feels different. It feels bigger. I think it's just because of this, 1911 cut there, but I guess it's the same length, but it is a lot wider. You can't take it apart to remove the spring. I don't remove the springs much because there's only I only shoot 10 mags, kind of my practice mags. Those are the ones I take apart and clean and stuff. But if you take this to a class that's not sunny, grassy ground, they get filled with, clay and dirt and dust. So, yeah, I look for my Bakelite mag. I couldn't find it. I know I have one Russian Bakelite mag. It came with one of the guns I bought a long time ago when people didn't want them. I don't know what happened to it. I'm sure it's around here somewhere. I lose these expensive mags. I keep it for my Chinese gun, my Chinese Type 56. But this is just kind of a rough overview of how, pretty much these mags, I believe these mags are obsolete, and they're fine if you need one to throw in the truck and stuff, but if I'm going to carry mags in my kit, I have my night vision gun as an AK and I keep 8 mags for it. If you take 8 times 4, that's 24 ounces. I'm sorry. I went to city school. No, 32, 32 ounces is 2 pounds. So just switching to polymer, you save two pounds on the front of your body and gun. That's crazy. Hopefully with some use, these two Kalashnikov Concern American-made mags will stand up. Well, I think they'll do good. And I know that Kalashnikov USA has put a lot of work into producing a very good system. And I believe that time will tell that they test out just fine. So with that, I appreciate you guys watching, and have a good day. And Merry Christmas.